Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. In this video we are going to learn about decap cells and why they are used in a chip. But before that, if you haven't subscribed to this channel, please do subscribe for more videos related to physical design. So without any further delay, let's get started. Let's try to understand the functionality of decap cells through the power requirements of this inverter, which is sitting somewhere inside a chip. Now this inverter will get its power from these power and ground rails. Now there is a high chance that the source of this VDD will not be anywhere nearer to this inverter. So by the time this VDD reaches the inverter, it will see a high voltage drop. As you can see, the voltage seen by this inverter will not be VDD, but it will be VDD minus delta V. And this is not only true for VDD, but it is true for VSS as well. But the only difference is this delta V, instead of getting subtracted from VDD, it will be added to VSS. Therefore, this VDD minus delta V is known as voltage true, and this change in VSS is known as ground bounce. Now you must be thinking, what will the value of this delta VDD and this delta VSS? So let me tell you, these power and ground rails are nothing but wires, and they have certain resistance and certain inductance. And as we know, voltage is also the current multiplied by resistance, and voltage is also inductance into di by dt. So when current flows through these wires, it sees a voltage drop, and this voltage drop is I into R, IR. It is also known as IR drop. And when current changes with respect to time, it sees in voltage drop L into di by dt. So collectively, the voltage drop seen by this inverter is IR plus L di by dt. But remember, this R and L is the resistance and inductance of this VDD rail. Now, if this voltage drop is greater than the noise margin of this inverter, then it might even lead to improper functionality of this inverter. Now what is noise margin? Noise margin is basically the maximum noise this inverter can handle. So now let's say the noise margin of this inverter is 0.3, and 1 minus 0.3 is 0.7. So anything less than the 0.7 will be considered as 0 by this inverter and not 1. So now let this delta VDD is 0.4. So 1 minus 0.4 is 0.6. So this inverter will consider that 0.6 as 0 and not 1. And therefore, it will lead to improper functionality. So now we have seen that if the voltage drop is greater than the noise margin of a cell, it can even lead to improper functionality of that particular cell, which is very dangerous. So here is where decap cells comes into picture. So what are these decap cells? These decap cells are essentially capacitors that holds a reservoir of charge, and they are generally placed near the power hungry cells. So whenever these cells switch, decap cells starts discharging themselves and provide the much needed instantaneous current to the cells and keeps the power supply constant. There are many types of decap cells, and in this video I am going to show you some of them. And the first one in line is NMOS only decap cell. As you can see, this is a NMOS transistor, and the gate of this transistor is connected to VDD rail, and the source and drain are shorted together and are connected to VSS rail. So this NMOS now acts like a capacitor, and this capacitor sits between VDD and VSS rail like this. So these are some other types of decap cells, and I'm going to give a brief overview that in what kind of situations we use which kind of decap cells. These NMOS only and PMOS only decap cells are generally used between blocks, whereas these other types of standard cells, which contains both NMOS and PMOS devices, are used within standard cell blocks. This is because within a standard cell, NVEL is already there and reserved for PMOS devices, and the lower half cell area is reserved for NMOS devices. So therefore, it is easier to put decap cells which contain both NMOS and PMOS. Whereas if you see for this NMOS only and PMOS only decap cell, It requires a complete P-well region, and this requires a complete N-well region. So it is preferable to put them between blocks. Now the question is when to use NMOS only decap and when to use PMOS only decap. Basically, NMOS only decap has a better frequency response than PMOS only decap. So for circuits with high frequency, we generally prefer NMOS only decap. But at the same time, PMOS gives very less gate leakage current when compared to NMOS. So that is why it is a trade-off which we need to make according to the requirement. This is a standard N plus P decap which used to be used earlier, but now for technologies below 90 nanometer, ESD risk has become a major concern. And this cross-coupled decap helps in preventing exactly that. Therefore, now it is a trade-off between ESD performance and transient response. So yeah guys, this is all I had about decap cells. I hope you understand what are decap cells and what is their functionality and on what basis we use them. Thanks for watching.